Welcome, Da Vinci families. I am Principal Davis, and I am honored to be here with you all this evening. The lights are off, so I want to introduce you to Ms. Wilson. Can you come up just a second? This is Ms. Wilson, our assistant principal. And she keeps our machine well-oiled. I am really excited and happy to have you all in our house this evening. It's been way too long since we've been able to have in-person performances. And as you know, as an art school, performing is a huge piece of our program. So we're really feeling pretty blessed to actually be able to put this on for you guys this evening. So Da Vinci provides a unique school experience for our students. Our students come to us and they really thrive and come into their natural and learned gifts. Our teachers and staff are absolutely dedicated. I can't say enough about our teachers. Outside of, they are truly, truly the absolute best. Mr. Jarolami and Mr. Muhammad have and continue to pour their hearts into our students or our musicians, and you'll get to witness that this evening. As a public school, we receive funds to support much of our program and the cost to help run our school. However, we are able to offer a thriving arts program because of all of your support. So thank you for your donation at the door, and please consider donating to our foundation. Your foundation dollars help us pay for extra programs such as FTE, and FTE is basically teachers, residents, artists, and much more. You can make a one-time donation to our foundation. You can do that online and go to PPS School Pay and select Da Vinci. Or you can make a monthly donation to our school. We appreciate all of your support. And a few items before we begin. So you received your tickets. Please, 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 please hold on to your ticket. What we need you to do is legibly write your student's first and last name on the back. And then we also need you to write the seat number that you're sitting in. Your seat number can be found on the back of your seat. And this is important because it helps us do our contact tracing in case of an unfortunate event. You will hold on to your tickets, and then at the end, as you exit, there will be someone out there to grab those tickets from you before you depart. Please silence your phones, and then, of course, you are absolutely welcome to take snap pictures of your kids. You're in for such a treat this evening, so sit back, enjoy the show, and I'm going to pass the mic off to Mr. Jarolami.
Well, thank you very much. We're super excited to be here. Just give me one second. We're going to get the beginning band out on stage. We are so happy to be here. The last music concert we had was December 19th, 2019. So we are 3 days shy of two full years without a concert. This is this year's beginning band. They've been doing a fantastic job this year. And we're going to start with a song called Crown of Majesty by Robert Sheldon. Thank you. very much. This next arrangement we're going to do is an arrangement of the Jamaican folk song Mary Ann, arranged by Robert Sheldon. It's called On Caribbean Shores. One of my favorite classes to teach. I don't know, that probably sounds crazy to some of you. But what's really, really fun about it is the progress is so noticeable. Earlier today, we actually listened to a recording of ourselves playing Hot Cross Buns on September 30th, when everybody had their instrument about 3 weeks-ish or so. And at the time, again, everybody's, this is so hard, there's so many, it's so tricky and stuff. And again, we listened to that today and we all kind of laughed. Like, wow, that was only, you know, 12 weeks ago. And the amount of progress and how fast progress happens with the beginning band is just really fun. It's one of the things I really like about working with beginners. So, and this group has been fantastic. This next song we're gonna do is called The Section Battle Rag by Brian Dalmages. Next number, we are going to have a stage transition, which throughout the night there's going to be, we have a very disparate group of ensembles performing tonight, so there is going to be a few minutes between each ensemble as we do stage transitions. Apologize for that, but there's no real way around it. So this last piece we're going to do is a song called Fanfare for a Winter Celebration, and it's a medley of a number of holiday festive type songs. You might recognize some little snippets and chunks in there. So thank you again for coming out. We've got a bunch of great ensembles coming for you, but let's hear it one more time for this year's beginning band. Just give us a couple of minutes and we'll have Tribe Door ready to go. Thank you. Let's hear it for Cogdalore. Have I told you how happy I am to be back in in-person school this year? Just give us give us 2 minutes and we'll get this transition over and we'll get after and jumping out here. Testing. Oh! All right, so good afternoon. All right, so a couple of things I want to say before we do this. My name is Hakeem, and I am so happy to have an actual performance for you guys. This is one of the things that does not translate over a computer screen. So it's really cool seeing faces and having these kids out here. Before we get started, I want to say a couple of things. The piece we're going to do for you guys is something that they learned in a little over 4 weeks. When the term started, we were just going through our little class, and then Mr. Jeremy said, hey, we got a performance December 16th. I'm like, oh, we got to put something together. So the cool thing about this, I want to explain to you guys a little bit what you're going to see, is they perform this themselves. I don't help at all. I just put it together, and they actually do all the stuff themselves. Adam Granger, a.k.a. Bodie, raise your hand. So I'm going to put Bodie on the spot a little bit. When we first started, Bodie basically led the group in push-ups. He was like the push-up champion. He did push-ups like basically more than he did drumming. But the reason I'm saying that is because he went from that to being the person who leads the piece. So, yes. So basically, I had to give you some responsibility. So the piece they're going to do for you guys is Lingen, led by Mr. Bowie. Thank you.
So that class is mostly sixth graders, and the name of the piece, it says in your program, is Lingen. And what made it cool about that is it kind of, their energy that they have is what actually made that piece. It's really a simple piece, but they have so much energy, and they're so energetic that they killed that piece. So one more. So this next group, the piece is a little bit more sophisticated, but it has just as much energy. This is the older group, mostly eighth graders, but I want to point out a couple of people like I did earlier the minute they get out of here. So the same, basically the same thing. They're all leading the piece. I'm not taking part in it, as you see. I'm going to step away and let them do their thing. I want to point out, soon as they get, I hope all the drums are here, because it's going to take a minute. And I appreciate everyone's patience as we're doing this. They have a little bit of a different setup. What I wanted to say, I wanted to point out a couple of people. First of all, the whole group is amazing, so I always feel bad when I point out a couple of people. But on top of the whole group being amazing, there are some points that are a little bit higher than the group being amazing. One of them is this gentleman right here with the really long hair. I'm pointing out Suhail because this is mostly eighth graders. And Suhail leads a section of the piece, and I thought it was amazing that someone who's in sixth grade to take that kind of responsibility and have all these eighth graders really respect him and really trust him to do this, so that's awesome. Next to Suhail is a whole bunch of names, Eleanor, Ella, Nora, LL, LL Cool J. Ella actually leads the fast part, same type of thing that they have to trust when the rhythm gets really, really fast and intense. Eleanor is actually controlling the fast part. So clap it up for Eleanor. And last but not least, Rock. Oliver Rock. I can't remember Rock's first name, so because Rock's last name is Rock, so that is the coolest last name. So Rock has, they are going to lead the song. So Rock, L, Suhail. All right. Thank you.
Well, thank you very much. That was Anthem and March by Ann McGinty. Our second piece is going to be Ritual Dance by Michael Story. From the whole COVID thing. So half of this ensemble, or a little bit more than half, started band last year, started beginning band online. And as I said earlier, I love beginning band. Last year I did not love beginning band. Trying to teach an instrument online was an incredibly frustrating experience, and both for myself and for the students. And a lot of the people that are on the stage fought through that last year. And for the other people, the eighth graders that were in beginning band, their sixth grade year, their entire seventh grade year was practicing at home by themselves. On top of that, with our different COVID safety issues here, this group is too big to practice inside the band room within the PPS safety protocols. So we have been practicing outside on the soccer field every day that we can. It's been cold and windy. And I have not complained. I've had them out there when it's 45 degrees and the wind is blowing and I can see them shivering, and for the most part everybody's just been really on board, and I really appreciate the work and effort they put in, because this is what we've had to do to make it happen. And I'm glad we did. And I'm glad we're here, and I'm thrilled to be back here in person. Sorry, I don't know if I've already said that, but I'm gonna say it again. This next piece is called Challenger Point by Timothy Johnson.
Thank you.
Thank you very, very much. And that was Colliding Visions by Brian Galmages. The last tune we are going to be playing with this group is Liberty March by James Swearingen. Then we're going to need a short transition to get the band stuff off and the choral risers up. Then there'll be the choir, and then we'll be done. That brings us to our final portion of the program, this year's Da Vinci Choir. We're going to kick it off. We're going to start off the program with a song called Wings.
Higher.
when programming music as a music educator, there are pieces that sometimes you do because of the artistic merit of the piece. There's pieces we sometimes do because of the educational merit of the content of the piece and what they're going to learn musically. And sometimes you just find a piece of music in the filing cabinet and then the choir sings it for fun and we have a good time with it. That's how this piece got programmed. Before we do our last number, I'd like to thank all of you for your support, not just this year, but over the last year and a half. By and large, things are running really smoothly here at DaVinci, and we're having a really good year, and I think that is in large part due to the community and the parental support and the teacher support and our kids' buy-in. So please, big hand to all of you guys, too, for all the help. So this is going to be our last number. We're going to close out it don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. And then we're just going to stay.
We skipped
a song. Boy, never mind. Our second to last song, our penultimate song, is going to be Homeward Bound.
Misty morning, when the moon has gone to
It don't mean a thing, but it got that swing. And then I believe Ms. Davis has a few words for us right afterwards. We're just going to hold tight on the rise. Okay. Thank you again so much for coming out. We really, really appreciate it. I cannot tell you after 2 years how much it means to me to have an in-person school concert again.
Do a thing, all you gotta do is see.
right. Did you enjoy the show? I'm really glad that you did. So for those of you who do not know, my girls actually go here. So Da Vinci is definitely has a special place in my heart. I chose to send my daughters here because not only did they have their own natural artistic skills, but I knew that they would be, those skills would be fostered here. And I trusted that my daughters would be well taken care of, which they are. Da Vinci is not only, it not only allows our students to be themselves, our program builds character and confidence. So again, thank you for your donations, and we sincerely appreciate your support. I'd like to thank our musicians and Drama Tech crew for putting on such a great show. Yes, you can clap. Thank you to the families, teachers, and staff who volunteered their time this evening in support of our students. They did all the behind the scenes work, which was quite a bit of work. And thank you to our Drama Tech. So all of the lights and tech is run by our students under the direction of our drama teacher, or Drama Tech teacher, Heidi. So thank you for all of that. A very, very special thank you to Shelly and Liz for all the time and energy that they put in to make sure that things are running smoothly. Let me tell you, if you know these ladies, then you know that things were going to be in order as they were this evening. All right, Mr. Girolami, again, so much gratitude for putting together such an amazing production in 4 weeks with all of the COVID-type procedures. So thank you so much.